Thomas Jefferson quoted two things that still stand as true today. The first being, tyranny is defined as that which is legal for the government, but illegal for the people. And the second one is, when the people fear the government, there is tyranny. But when the government fears the people, there is liberty. All right, guys, I picked up this story from a channel called 11 Alive News. And this scenario is from April 25th, 2019. Tyler Griffin was suspected of driving under the influence by two Atlanta police officers. Although Tyler wasn't aware that it was the police that was following him, he eventually pulled over to a private driveway by himself. The heavy blue lights were on and quickly approaching the driveway. That's when Griffin realized that it was the police that had been following him. As the initial police officer charges the vehicle, he has his firearm trained on Tyler. That's when the police demand that he exit the vehicle. Although Griffin did comply with the officer's orders as he exited the vehicle, that's when things went from bad to worse for Griffin. This tyrant cop is on a whole new level of crazy. You guys gotta see this.
Hey, stop the car! 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 Get out of the f***ing car, Atlanta police! Get out of the f***ing car! Get out the car now! Get out the car!
And Buchanan.
Let's go. Get out of the car. Get out of the car. Let's move. What are you doing, man?
What do you mean, what am I doing?
Tell me, what are you doing?
Wait a minute, hold on. Don't grab me like that.
No, hold on. No, hold on. No, hold on. You do not swipe my hands from me. Do you understand?
All right, guys, let's go over this real quick. You can see where Tyler steps out of the vehicle. The police officer puts his hand on Tyler's shoulder. That's when Tyler just lightly brushes the cop's hand back. That's when Captain Insano comes in for the freaking tackle. Apparently, Tyler must have said something bad about Bobby Boucher's
until they
mama.
Told him to get out of the car.
Tell me, what are you doing?
Wait a minute, hold on. Don't grab me like that.
Until they told him to get out of the car.
Tell me, what are you doing?
Wait a minute, hold on. Don't grab me like that.
Hey, you got anybody else in the car? You got any weapons or anybody else in the car?
Now you can tell the authoritarianism of this guy is at its peak. I mean, this guy is nuts. Like, ready to taste some blood crazy. Because what he just done was completely uncalled for.
Nah, nobody in the car.
Nah,
that. He going. We're not even gonna do no, none of that. He stinks like alcohol. He can't drive. We got that one. Give me another cup, please.
And to help you guys better understand, Tyler never hid the fact that he was driving while intoxicated.
You didn't do it. Push that officer up. You like that? No.
I would never.
You did though.
Well, guys, I am just perplexed. I mean, this cop and his convoluted way of thinking is no different than any other person in the local insane asylum. With this authoritative status mentality, these cops really feel as if they have a higher claim over your rights and your property and your life. But we all know this is just how status think. Also, this is a prime example that power corrupts, as this cop cannot understand that how putting his hands on a non-violent offender who is cooperating isn't a tyrannical action. He only sees that Griffin has disobeyed his commands. Therefore, that's all this cop needs to make Griffin a criminal. And as for like an authoritative or status person, he sees Griffin wanting to protect himself as a diss to him, or as they call it, disorderly conduct.
You didn't do it. Push that officer up. You like that? No,
I would never.
You did though.
Ow!
Let's go.
Ow.
We're gonna get up. Tuck your leg under you.
I can't move my leg. You guys.
Is it broken?
I mean, you guys heard it, but.
Tuck it under you and use that to get up. So you need to go to the hospital? We'll take you to the hospital.
And if you can't go ahead, you get up.
You want to try and take off on me? I'm telling you to stop. I'm watching you spin the tires and you back up and I ran up on you. You realize you were stuck and that's why you got out of the car. Put your foot under you and get up.
Griffin later stated in a report to news media that when he was tackled by the officer, he could feel and hear his ankle breaking. And just when you stop and think that this officer is going to show some remorse for his wrongdoings, he immediately switches his mentality over to blaming Tyler for the reason he was tackled and for the reason that his ankle is broken.
Where's your license at?
It's in my pocket. Why just would you guys do that for me?
No, don't even try that.
Don't try. How much you have to drink tonight?
I would not do that.
How much you have to drink tonight?
I didn't have that much.
All right. How much is not that much?
Just tell me to get the illness.
How much is not that much?
I would not do that. Oh, my God.
You wouldn't do what?
Ow. Why would you guys?
Because you can push my hands away. Absolutely, you get taken down. You swipe my hand out the way.
I would not.
You got tucked down. That's what happened.
I would not do that. I admire the police.
Everything's on camera. Don't try it. You're not protecting anything. We're as drunk as you are. You stink like alcohol and you can't drive.
No.
You almost hit us on Hal Mill.
I did not do that.
You were driving on the wrong side of the road.
No, I did not.
You drove up. You drove the wrong way up this road.
I was not.
We were behind you the entire time.
I agree. I was not.
You can fight it all in court then.
We go to 12 clear of the 72T.
Griffin claims that these cop stories are flat out lies and that things didn't happen that way. And you know what? I believe him. And here's why. These two police officers are claiming that Griffin was driving in the wrong direction, coming towards him, nearly causing an accident and running them out of the road. Then they turn around and claim that they had been following Griffin for some time. Now you tell me, do you think these two crazy policy enforcing police officers are going to let somebody drive down the road in the wrong direction, nearly causing them to crash, and they're just going to continue to follow in an unmarked car with no pursuit lights on? I don't think so. Because Griffin didn't realize he was being followed by the police until he pulled over, and then they pulled in the driveway and turned their lights on. That's when Griffin realized it was the cops that was following him. So therefore, these cops are lying.
Okay, 1184, this guy, he went off a pretty high ledge with his vehicle. Gonna need an 85 to get it out. However, there's another vehicle for residents here blocking it, so I can't get anybody to the door. May not be able to get his vehicle out anytime soon, but I do need a unit to help with the transport, please.
I'm 1107
in. I'm never out. I'm never out. I'm never out. Detention, start miles 817561.
I copy starting mileage 817561 at.
Yeah, I got it.
347 hours.
I'm waiting for the transport to get here. You see that?
Yeah, I see.
That's because you drove off of this ledge. Because you had no idea where you're going.
I did.
You knew where you were going?
You almost hit us head on. I would never do
that. That's what started all this.
You may not intentionally have done that, but you did it.
That's why we got behind you in the first place. And then you went up the one way.
Which, I mean...
1195 radio. Can you raise 1184 for two, please?
Tried.
I would never do that.
When you ran the stop sign making a left.
You're sitting here banging on, and you're still backing up and going. Come on, man.
You realize you were stuck when you were trying to go up here. Who are you talking to, man?
I'm still talking to you, man.
Who are you talking to?
This is one reason that I really love doing these videos. These cops get caught up in the moment and they let their frustration and their anger take hold of them, and you really get to see their true colors. And as they forget, it's all on film. When, you know, the person who's being accused of something is usually trying to stay calm and explain their way out of it, while the cop is demonstrating taking it from 0 to 10 instead of trying to de-escalate the situation. And it's all captured, and we can go back and watch it, and there's nothing that they can do to prove otherwise.
That's my debit card. Any license?
And
in my left pocket.
You like 1108, 1112,
clear of the 1015.
Okay, I see it.
1112, show me
Don't argue with me.
I'm not arguing with you.
Huh?
Hey, cut
his car off.
Cut it off.
You got one coming?
What?
You got one coming?
I got an 85 coming, but I don't know if I'm gonna get this car out.
I don't think so. Did you try knocking on that door?
Yeah, nobody's coming.
Alright.
Alright. To reiterate things and wrap things up, let's go over this. Griffin is laying on the ground because he was tackled by a police officer while cooperating for a driving while intoxicated charge. He should be innocent until proven guilty, when in this case, he's actually guilty until proven innocent. Unable to stand up on his own, Griffin is still lying in the gravel parking lot while police are ransacking his vehicle, going through his stuff, and looking for a way to get his car out so it could be impounded. So not only did they infringe on his rights and put hands on him and tackle him to the ground for basically cooperating, they completely ignored Tyler and his severe leg injury, all in order to better their case against him as they searched his vehicle and his person. They showed no moral care for an individual person that which they themselves caused the bodily harm to. All because of these two cops and their tyrannical actions, Griffin now cannot work and he has to use a motorized cart to function in everyday activities. As for now, Tyler Griffin claims that he was mistreated and abused by these cops and their unlawful methods of control. This case is under investigation pending any further information for now. Guys, don't forget to leave this video a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure and go ahead and subscribe. Also, leave your thoughts in the comment section below about this tyrannical cop and how he handled this situation. And until then, guys, I will see you all in the next video. I'm a